types of sales manager. The sales manager can be classified into certain categories mainly on the basis of the nature of the functions performed by them. So experts of modern management process have divided a management into two classes, that is administrative and one is operative management. So administrative management is basically a thinking process, and operative management is more concerned with the doing. So the types of sales manager consist of mainly three, like administrative sales manager, operative sales manager, and administrative cum operative sales manager. So there are various types other than that also. There is assistant sales manager, product line sales manager, marketing staff manager, divisional regional sales manager, brand sales manager, and a sales supervisor. First one is administrative sales manager. So the administrative sales managers are found normally in highly integrated sales organizations selling multiple lines of products in the national and international markets, and he is known by alternative titles such as vice president, in charge of sales, director of marketing, general sales manager, and a marketing manager. So he is the administrative sales manager. So he is primarily concerned with the coordination and integration of all the company activities relevant to marketing. So he is not an authority on design, so engineering, manufacturing, and finance. And contrary to these, like he is an authority on sales and profits, so it does not mean, however, that he can be from the departments and their functions. So in addition to the crucial task of the coordinating marketing with other company activities, he is to coordinate with the activities of his own sales organization within and outside advertising and a sales console. So he is responsible for the sales planning that involves integration of sales personnel, merchandising, advertising, and promotion, and also a financing, a distribution, a network. So he is responsible for all these activities. So field sales manager. So the field sales managers are operating sales manager is in a line sales executive reporting directly to the administrative sales manager. So the operative sales manager works under the direction, guidance, and supervision of the general sales manager. So he is like mainly responsible for the effective implementation of the sales plan and policies developed by the administrative sales manager. So he is known for the personal direction and control of the sales personnel, and hence spends major portion of his time in the field of supervision of the work of the sales force. And manpower maintenance of the sales organization is the basic task of this executive. So he is to recruit, select, train, supervise, stimulate, evaluate, and control and route the sales force of the organization. Next one is administrative cum field sales manager. So the in case of smaller organization, we come across such sales managers who combines the functions of the administrative and executive sales officers. So administration and field operations cannot go together. So however, the size and the economy points force many units to combine the distinct roles of administration and field operation. So as an administrator, he plans, organizes, directs, and coordinates the, as a field operator, he guides and supervises and controls the activities within the sales organization. So like thinking and doing are the done by the same person. That goes against a very idea of specialization for an administrator. Is a thinker and a line officer as a doer. Next one is assistant sales manager. So generally the administrative sales manager is assisted by assistant sales manager in the administrative functions of the planning, analyzing, direction, and coordination. So he coordinates the work of sales staff that is specialized in advertising, sales promotion, research, merchandising, and dealer relations. So he may also handle sales office personnel records and routine. He acts as a think between the headquarters and the field sales manager, at a distance. So he is not a surprise if he discharges the functions of the field sales manager, because he acts as a both line and staff officer in the sales organizations. Next one is product line sales manager. Product line sales manager, the company that markets variety of product has such product line sales manager responsible for one or group of products in the product line. So he is also known as the product or a brand manager. So he is responsible for not only for sales, but also for production, research, development, and planning, advertising, and profit for the product or the group of the products in the question. So he is to report to the marketing manager who coordinates the work of several product sales managers. Marketing staff manager, he is the, like, a title only suggests that the marketing staff manager is not a line officer. So he is one of the staff specialists who are delegated some of the responsibilities of administrative sales manager. So these are the specialists in the areas of marketing, research, sales promotion, merchandising, advertising, sales planning, sales personnel, and distributor, dealer relations, and budget sales, finance, traffic sales, everything. And these staff managers, being non-line officers, have no field task. So these managers are accountable for analyzing the needs of the marketing organizations in respect of their specific areas of specialization, developing plans and recommending solutions to the problems encountered through the open. So divisional and regional sales manager, like in all the national organizations, one comes across the these divisionals or regional sales managers. So these are the known as a district sales manager, who are responsible for the delegated sales operational duties on a territorial basis. So they report assistant sales manager or the field sales manager, who act as a liaison officer with the headquarters. So the functions of divisional or regional sales managers are similar to those of the field sales manager, who is in charge of several divisions or regions, and hence divisional or regional managers. Brand sales manager, in case of sales organization that operates branches or a local sales offices in major cities of the country, so one is to come across such branch sales managers. Like, brand sales managers is line executive responsible for the direction of the small group of salesmen calling on the consumers or dealers in the branch area. So he recruits, selects, and trains the sales people with the guidance of divisional or regional sales manager, to whom he reports. So he works along with the salesman in the organization and in the field of supervise their sales activities, holds a periodic sales meetings, so evaluate sales performances, and help in a key account. So if a warehouse is attached to a branch, so if he supervises warehousing activities too, so he is responsible for only particular branch. Sales supervisors, a sales supervisor is a line sales manager who supervises normally 8 to 14 salesmen. So under him only there will be 8 to 14 people whom he is going to be supervised. So he is seen in branch sales office of the national sales organization having branches all over the nation. So he is responsible to the local branch sales manager. In case there is no branch sales manager, then he is responsible to the sales manager of the company directly. So his work is to train and motivate the sales people under his charge. So his supervision, guidance, and coaching helps in building up a more confident sales personnel. So he is the key communicator in the transmission of information and sales policies of new products, promotions, and marketing programs between the higher ups and individual salesmen. The types of salespeople are the order takers, inside order takers, delivery salespeople, outside order takers, order creators, missionary salespeople, and order getters. So the order takers are not expected to persuade customers to buy the company's product or increase their quantity of purchase. So they are supposed to book customers' orders and pass on the information to relevant people in the company. So they are expected to be accurate. They are also expected to have a information about when the order that has been booked will be delivered to the customers. And customers will often inquire about the delivery date from them. They should have answers. So order takers are also being prompted to at least customers to buy certain other products of the company besides the ones that they are already are buying, or increase their quantities of the purchaser. Next one is inside order takers. The retail sales assistants are typical inside order takers. So the customers has full freedom to choose products without the presence or influence of the salesperson. The salesperson's task is to transactional. So he receives payments and passes over the goods to the customers. Delivery salespeople. Delivery salespeople are primarily concerned with the delivering the product. So there is a little attempt to persuade customers to increase the order, changes in order size, or customers. And driver. So though delivery salespeople do not try to influence demand, winning and losing an order is heavily so dependent on reliability of the delivery. Outside order takers, like the salesperson visits the customers, but they primarily respond to the customer's request rather than actively seek to the persuade them. So they are being replaced by the more cost efficient telemarketing teams who call customers and book their orders. Order creators, the prime objective of the order getters is the to convince our customers to buy the company's product. So at some stage in order getting process, the salesperson should understand the customer's requirements and convince him that his company's product serve his requirements best. So some salespersons get too excited about persuading the customers to buy the company's product. So the customers feel embarrassed and angry when salesperson become very insistent, though the customer has made it clear that he does not want to buy the product. So a salesperson should avoid such situations and should gracefully back off when the customers does not seem interested in the product. So if salesperson or salespeople do not take his precaution, the tribe of salesperson would be collectively shunned by the customers. Missionary salespeople. In some industries, what happened, notably pharmaceutical and building industry, the sales task is not to close the sales, but to persuade the customers to specify the seller's product. So medical representatives calling on doctors cannot make a direct sale since the doctors does not buy drugs to prescribe them for a patient. So architects also act as a specifiers rather than the buyer. So in these situations, the selling task is to educate and build goodwill for the company. So order getters are typically selling jobs where a major objective is to be persuade the customers to make a direct purchase. So these are the frontline salespeople who are supported by the technical support salespeople and also with the merchandisers.